Hello then, it's me and my beacon face bunny. kind of lost it. Oh yeah, this is the maximum zoom. So, sorry about that, I cut the last video. What happened? I think something, I don't actually remember what happened. I couldn't record next. So we gonna continue what we left. So we left on the handler, card handling trigger. As all card triggers, you need to place it on checkpoint, and because most card gadgets only work on applies only to specific only applies to the player power up. Card tweakers, right? Only apply to the card. Only apply to the card, so you can only place on checkpoint, because you can place logic only on checkpoint to the player. Oh my god, okay, I overcomplicated. But this affects the card, so you need to place it on checkpoint, because logic, when you place stuff on checkpoint, logic on checkpoint is gonna be applied to the player that spawns from that checkpoint. So yeah, so we did last time we did AI stuff and character impression, which is kind of far advanced than LittleBigPlanet 2, and actually got more animations. Let me remind you. It got animations like look back, look right, and also yes, no, yavn, something that LittleBigPlanet 2 players would like. Creators, I mean. So, handling trigger. Let's back to the work. Handling trigger is like physics trigger that we explained in last time, but it's physics for the card. And how it moves, how it behaves, and anything. So there's actually few modes, drive modes, for a specific vehicle. We got cart, we got tank, which is slower and got some tank-based stuff. And we got direct control, which are, as I expect, it works like movers. So, I guess we can demo it, why not? To test that, gonna use selector. Actually, you know, let's move this to Controlinator, since Controlinator is a microchip. I can just start to use to. Okay, selector. Selector, we're gonna set it to 3. We're gonna make, oh yeah, copying sucks and carting, kind of. Also, it doesn't always appear, which is even more annoying. We need to clone. Okay. Oh yeah, okay, so first one we're gonna use card as a direct control. Autopilot, I think it's something you should expect. It works like, it follows the truck without steering. This won't work on Arena, so we won't demo this one, autopilot. And kart, which is standard kart, tank is a slower kart with different physics a little bit, and direct control. Actually, I didn't test direct control, I actually don't know what it is, so let's experiment and see what will happen. That's how you test stuff in karting. You need to know how things behave in the game. Let's use D-pad. What is interesting, you don't need to freaking disable Puppet to actually use D-pad like in Little Big Planet 2, because you can't use Puppet during race, which is standard thing. Who would stop just to use Puppet? Only practice mode got Puppet. So yeah, here we go. Let's test this. So as you can see, this is direct force mode, which is direct control. Direct control works this way, that it moves with analog stick. You don't use the gas, you don't use anything, just analog stick. And it's like a mover, practically. Okay, let's try different mode. I think this is normal karting mode. Oh yeah, check this out. It doesn't have momentum. That's the tank mode. It's like karting mode. It feels like karting mode, but it doesn't have momentum. See? You can lower the speed and it will be slower. And normal karting mode. And yeah, and autopilot. And so on. Autopilot works only on track, and it will follow automatically the track, like autopilot power up. Like this boxing glove, just like we've seen. Okay, let's back. Except different modes, we also got extra tweaks, since this is physics of the kart, so it got even more tweaks. Let's set this to default to 3, I guess. Camera related, so it will make camera rotate with kart or not. Local rotation will make and it won't able to rotate the kart, steer the kart. It's perfect when you make 2D level. 2D level. We got top speed, which is not speed overall. It's a top speed, so. It's a maximum speed that kart can have. I'm gonna show you. So 60, it's a half, double the speed. This is acceleration, which how fast it will reach the top speed. Handling, how much steering is sensitive, right? Drifting, no comment on that, simply disable the drifting. Drift cone. This is probably the angle on which you drift. So we got drift speed also and drift time. There's another drifting, I don't know what the hell this is, and it also got angle or something. You can disable drifting, you can disable jumping. And you can actually get height of jumping, so let's try this out. Let's get this to maximum and see how far we can jump. spinning is during jumps, you can spin with right analog stick and you can disable it and also increase speed. air control, during jump you can use analog stick to control the car, but you can disable that, and you can control how much air control is sensitive and powerful. Grabble, which is actually don't know. You can use grabble power up, but yeah, I think a slap. You can slap with when you're on the ground. You can slap with right stick. If you don't know that, if you didn't hear that, you can disable engage engine audio too. And that's it. Okay, let's see what the tweaks I we made. Top speed and top hop, and see how far we can jump. So this is top speed. Not much fast. But this is maximum hop. So this is how you can tweak maximum jumping. Whee! Cool, you can create cool track with this. Oh, yeah, you can spin. So yeah, so this is it. So this is handling puker, which is equivalent to the physics tweaker, but it's for kart. Okay, let's kill this. Let's leave selector. It might be still useful for the specific tweaks. Okay, now we're gonna explain you kart transformer. But first, kart transformer, yeah, kart transformer transforms kart allows to transform kart to object or different kart, I think. No, only object. So to explain how this works, first we need to show you how to make a kart object. So it's a object that behaves like kart. So we can create, for example, huge block. Let's make it a little smaller and shorter. And draft some odd shape. Oh wait, oh yeah, forgetting that when you got rotation you can draw. Let's draw some odd shape. Something like that. And now, to turn this object into kart, there's two gadgets that allows you to do that. Most important one is a kart chassis. It's a wheels of your kart. You can avoid kart cockpit that I'm gonna show you in future. But let's first start with the kart chassis, since this is the most important part in making a kart out of the object. So you place it on the back, or you can make it even on the side, whatever. And as you can see on the arrow, it shows the forward direction. So when you place it on this position, it will place, and that it will drive in this direction. So let's place it here, for example, and this is gonna be forward, right? Since we placed this here. Another piece is a kart cockpit. Kart cockpit is just for decoration purposes. When this is gonna be a kart, this object, cockpit, the sagball will appear, right? You don't need to place that. If you don't place this, The Sackboy won't be visible when you transform your card to this object. So let's place it here. And now, of course, to complete the process, you simply need to capture this object. So let's do that. Functions, yeah. Yeah. Capturing is a little odd and a little feels unfamiliar, but you just picking and that's it. So let's do this, and we're gonna plug cycle to the transform. And to finalize the whole thing, you need to use a card transformer to transform your card into something else with the logic. You can simply not wire anything and it will start with this object. But when you wire, you can transform anything to this object. So as you can see, our object appeared. Only objects that have chassis, card chassis, will appear here. So here we go. And let's see how this works. Probably gonna be ugly. But okay, let's try. So we start with this. And we press cycle and boom! Here's our ultimate card. Kind of invisible. As like you can see, it's a card. And when you release it, it's gonna back to your card. So you can create some really interesting stuff with this. So this is card transformer, transforming a card to any object you want. Okay. So another piece. So this is card transforming. Transforming cards to objects with the chassis and cockpit. Right? Okay. So a card transformer finished. Another piece is power up loadout. What it is, it allows you to give a specific power up to the player without even making item. You might remember in Little Big Planet 2, you need to emit power up to give it to the player by logic. Here you got this awesome gadget that do that for you and doesn't need any emitting. And by placing it without any connection, it will automatically give this power up on the start. Yeah, something that it would also would be useful in Little Big Planet 2, and makes me more wonder. Okay, I'm probably gonna record that track. And it makes me even more don't understand what people thinking that logic sucks in karting, because there's a lot of new stuff that is actually would be useful in Little Big Planet 2. So we got Grabinator and Grabby Hook. There's no Weaponator. There's different gadget for weapons. So let's use selector, and we're gonna make switching between power-ups as an example. So we're gonna place this here. And as you can see, you can control with what player got power, which power up. Please, whatever, whoever make another Little Big Planet platforming game, if there's any in development, please implement something like stuff like this. Really. Because this stuff is very useful for all Logic players. I mean creators. So yeah. And see how it works. There's no visual effect. Yeah, we got Grubble here. There's no visual effect, but I'm sure it works. Definitely. Oh, here we go. You can see now. Let's go here. Here we go. The Grubbinator. And we're gonna disable. Oh. Okay, never mind. But it works for sure. Definitely it works. So, except the. Except the power up loadout tweaker, power up loadout gadget, there's also weapon loadout, which is the same thing but for weapons. This should be more visible, definitely, because we simply set stuff. So let's so to do that we got, yeah, you can make it replace current weapons, so if somebody got a weapon already it will be ignored, that this tweaker gonna be it won't replace the existing weapon, but we want to replace existing weapons, so we leave this on. Okay, so as you remember in the past, in Little Big Planet karting, objects are power up, actual power ups. Same as you can see my power ups here that we made. So, for example, if you want to use boxing glove, you pick here. Let's another weapon, for example. Let's use the shockwave. Yeah, it's a self-weaponator. And other power-up, let's use a lightning bolt, paintinator, lone pump, multi-missile, strike missile, leader attack. There's some flashbang. Oh, I don't know that. Oh, I think I know what it is. Mine, Battle Red Seeker, Blue Rocket. Okay, let's use Blue Rocket. So as it's a weapon loadout, it will set the power up with the D-pad, as we said. And as you can see, we got missile, I press D-pad, it will change the power up, as we configure the weapon loadout. And when we use... Just gonna use... And here we got electricity. And as you can see, As long you got signal, it will give another one to the player. Oh, good kill. So yeah, when you keep the signal, I actually didn't know that, when you keep the signal, it will start regenerating the power up when you use the power up, actual power up. So this way you can control, for example, disabling weapon and giving weapons, and without by avoiding these weaponators. So you don't need to emit them, like we would need to do that in LittleBigPlanet 2. So yeah, this is weapon loadout, which is power loadout, but power up loadout, but for the weapons. Another card tweaker is a card scale tweaker. Yeah, this one is pretty fun. As name's saying, it allows you to scale the card to specific size, and you can control this with logic, of course, as everything that is quicker. So you got transition time, you got also scale string, which I believe allows you to control the scale with analog signal, but it kind of didn't work when I tried that. I don't know actually if this is right. And so we got shrinking, the scale maximum scale is 4 times bigger, and smallest is half times bigger, and one for the normal. So let's see. So scale tweaker allow you to resize the card itself. So boom, and we bigger. Here's, for example, here's our AI that placing, and you can see the difference. And now let's shrink. Whee! Oh, shrinking doesn't work for some reason. But scaling up works. And we freaking huge, huge card now. Yeah, so this is Scale Tweaker, pretty fun, interesting thing for the power-ups, very cool. And Cartinator is equivalent, it doesn't matter anyway, we already got all the card tweakers explained. So Cartinator is an inversion of Controlinator. It's actually equivalent of Controlinator on Sackbot, but it also works for the player. But instead of seeing input Controlinator, we actually see the card and specific functions of the card, which practically allows to reconfigure all the controls. And something interesting that normally you don't have in controls, you can use this as a movinator. Mover of the card and rotator of the card. So let's try it. We're gonna use left right. Maybe not. Let's use spinning. Spin. Look back. Oh, so look back, it will probably reverse you back. Or maybe not. It will make you see, look on the back, I think. Okay, yeah, it's looking back, I think. Probably. But let's set this to spin. And the other one, we're gonna make it move on the side. So this is extra controls that you doesn't have normally when you play, and Control Inactor has that. So I will show you. I think I killed something. Okay, let's see. Maybe it's some kind of bug. There's also tweak inside Controlinator, which allows you control vibrator is not connected. Let's make this yes. Yeah, so if you don't have this tweak on, it will disable all the controls, other controls that are not connected. But the one that I connected doesn't work for some reason. I don't know, maybe it's for something else. I remember it worked back then. Maybe I connect this wrongly. Again, up down to the rotation spin and left right. To the left right direction. I hope it worked now. Doesn't work. I don't know. But as I said, Controlinator is an input for the controls, logic to the... It's an input of the controls of the card to the logic. So you can control the card with the logic. And other controls than this Movinator's parts, I mean movers and rotator, you got all the controls you can have in the card. So for example, you got jump over here, you got accelerate over here, you got agility, which is probably grappling, you can control horn for yourself, and you can make music with this on the sequencer. Steering, of course, brake, and here's weapon control too. For the secondary weapon and secondary. Wonder what secondary do. Maybe it doesn't use them right now. So yeah, this is Coordinator. You simply plug inputs to the inputs and you can control stuff with the logic. So for example, you can steer with the with the buttons, if you want. You just place it into a signal combiner and plug it over here. Okay, so we did all the... We did all the card tweakers, and as I said, all card tweakers works only on checkpoint. Those are special. Oh wait, there's one more. Reset. Oh yeah, I forgot about reset. Okay, but reset is easy. It simply kills the card. Another thing that would be useful on the Big Planet 2. Without any emitting, killing without any emitting, right? So you got kill, reset 2. Oh, I think I know. This allows you to reset to specific checkpoints, since checkpoints I think also got labels. So you can make respawn the player in a specific checkpoint, which is very nice. But yeah, we plus place this on the cycle, so let's demo it. Let's drive somewhere else. Over here, and as you can see, I place cycle. It resets me. So yeah, this is reset, simple thing, also useful if you want to reset the players to this, respawn all the players, you simply place reset and plug it to something wireless like receiver, and you can reset all the players. And yeah, another thing is movers and rotators. There's not much over here. I believe they're still making movers and rotators because gyroscope simply sucks. To demo, actually there's nothing much in rotator. A thruster makes object move. Like that. Thruster is a mover. There's acceleration, which is speed. There's apply to the center. If this is on, it will move object ignoring the location of the engine itself. But when you turn it this off, it will apply force in the engine position. And local space, so it will apply the direction orientation of the engine. If not, it will apply straight. Yeah, local. It's kind of like mover, but it's not mover. It's an engine and makes noise, which is some people are annoyed because of that. People, I hope they're gonna implement real movers. Other thing is rotator. Rotator you place on the specific plane you want to rotate. It's actually, yeah, it's mover. And actually you can demo this here. So you simply put this on to max. Let's make this dynamic. And you can see it spins like a rotator. And when you plug it over here, as I said, it's like a 2D rotation. It will spin in this axis. Okay, since I noticed we got this object to test, I will show you the thruster. So let's place this in maximum speed. And as you can see, it fires the jet. Now, apply center. We're gonna, for the demo of this, we're gonna place somewhere over here. And check this out. Maybe not. Maybe let's put this on the bottom. We will be able to kind of. Okay, so as you can see, it's disabled. It will spin the object because it's not centered, but when this is on, the object should be go up. See, so this tweak applies activates. And when you disable it, it will apply the position of the engine. And if it's on the side, it will spin the object instead of going up. And local space, as you can believe, it applies the local space. Another thing is gyroscope, which freaking annoys me as hell. Let me show you. I was working on this. This kind of shape. And I tried a lot of things using this shape. And yeah, here's anti-gravity. It's going a little bit down. There's no any signals over here. There's a target up. There's some rocket which should work like rocket rotator this way. And there's also a follow which it's look at. It's like a look at rotator. But when you use gyroscope, it's turning you up, right? But it doesn't much listen about. Oh crap. Yeah, you need to watch out. You can't make select and press because it's gonna delete your object. And as you can see, it doesn't listen. It actually points up. Like you can see, orientation is here. I think it should go in this condition, it should go there, but it's going down. So it's odd. And orientation doesn't matter. You can place over here. And it will still move the object to some different location. So it's kind of broken, this gyroscope. Okay, so next thing is sensors. Weapon blast sensor. Weapon blast sensor is like paintinator sensor or projectile sensor. When you hit the missile, it will count up. And there's nothing much here. You got max hit, so it counts how many hits. Reset when full, so it will reset the counter when you fill it up. Hit counter of the project when weapon hits, right? It will reset, so it will send impulse and send another impulse, and so on. When you turn this off, when it fills, it will stay filled. Ignore friendly fire. That's interesting. A freaking interesting thing. Okay, never mind. There's also include rigid connections, which will allow to detect the weapon hits in any side of the glued object or not. Invert output, which is another thing, and so on. Another sensor, player sensor. Yeah, so you got range, as you can see. There's a quite a range. It's 50 maximum. But what is interesting, you got different shape of range, which is something that some people suggested in the Little Big Planet 2, right? You can filter the detection to a specific team, right? So it will only detect, for example, team 3 players. Wait until a lap, so it will wait for detection for a specific lap. It only, of course, as you may guess, works only with tracks. Require all players, it's like Little Big Planet 2, it will require all players to be in the range of the player sensor to actually detect it. I wonder if this works with team. So team, all team players need to be in range. That would be awesome. But I don't have players to test that now. Number of players, which is, you know, how much players you need to make it trigger. So yeah, player sensor, a little bit more advanced because there's a team. There's also a lab settings, and as all sensors now got two shapes of the ranges. So another one is of course tag sensor. As I said before, there is a problem with the tag sensor. It's a range. There's a limit range, and it's even smaller than player sensor. And this is, I believe, this is the reason why they implemented the receiver and transmitter, because this is limited. I don't know why. Maybe there's some processing issues with that. There's a count, of course. You can also control shape of the range, which same as player sensor. And of course, you can filter tag, specific tag with specific label. And you can make it output value string, so it will forward the signal from the tag. Or you can make closeness, which will make signal stronger when it's closer to the tag sensor. So yeah, this is tag sensor. Tag, of course, we can skip that, it's just a tag. Visible to radar. Why not we try this, what this happens? I actually didn't test that. Okay, let's make it green and say I am here. And see if this gonna work as I expected this to work. Visible to radar. This is gonna be interesting. I am here. Let's see how this is gonna work. Oh yeah, as you can see, it shows on the radar over here. Which is actually cool. But it doesn't show any text. Okay, oh crap, we out of range. We made freaking arena annoying a little bit.